These two guitars are both Fender Custom Shop Eric Clapton signature Stratocasters. They're meant to replicate Eric Clapton's iconic Blackie guitar. The only problem is one of these is a fake. Now these appear to be almost identical, and if you don't know what to look for, you could easily get scammed. So in this video, I'm going to tell you the story of how I ended up buying a fake Stratocaster, and then I'm going to show you what the differences are between a fake one and a real one, and I'll reveal which one of these two is the fake. I'll compare the two side by side, and I'll go through each part to show you the differences and the things that you should look for if you're looking to buy a Stratocaster, particularly on the used market, so that you can protect yourself from getting scammed. So this is the fake one. If you were able to figure that out already, you probably don't need to watch the rest of this video. But if not, then make sure you do, because I'll give you some valuable tips so that you can protect yourself. But first, let me tell you the story of how I ended up buying this Stratocaster. So like many of you, I enjoy looking at the local listings on Craigslist and Facebook Marketplace. I'm always searching for the next deal. And recently, I've been looking to buy an Eric Clapton signature model Stratocaster, preferably a custom shop model. When I saw the listing for this guitar, it caught my eye. It said Fender Stratocaster Eric Clapton Blackie Replica. And when I zoomed in on some of the photos, I saw the custom shop logo, and so I was quite intrigued. But I noticed the price was a little bit low, and then as I started looking more at the photo and looking at more of the details of the guitar, I noticed some things that were a little bit off from what a custom shop Eric Clapton model should be. So I sent a message to the seller and I asked them to give me some more information on exactly what this guitar was. Now the seller was actually upfront right away and told me that this was a Chinese replica of the Fender Stratocaster. It was not actually a custom shop model. It wasn't even really a Fender. So initially I said, okay, no thank you. I'm not interested in this. And then I thought about it throughout the day and I thought, what if somebody buys this guitar and they're not as honest as this original seller, and they try and sell this as an actual custom shop Fender Stratocaster and scam somebody out of their money. I thought, if I could buy this, then I would be able to keep it out of the hands of somebody that's dishonest. Now, obviously there's more than just this one fake Stratocaster out there, but I thought if I could get this one, I could make a video showing this compared to a real one and show you exactly how you can tell the difference between a fake one and a real one to protect yourself from getting scammed. So I messaged the seller back and we negotiated a bit and we got it down to a reasonable price and I ended up purchasing this guitar. Now as luck would have it, 2 days later, another ad came up for a real custom shop Eric Clapton signature model, which I ended up purchasing, which is the other guitar that I was holding. Which of course works out really well because now I can show you exactly side by side a fake Stratocaster and a real one. So let's go ahead and move into a close-up shot of these two guitars side by side. When you see the two guitars side by side, you may notice the color is a little bit different, but that's actually not one of the factors that can help you determine whether it is fake or not. The one on the left is the real one, and that's actually a midnight blue. So it does look kind of black in the video, but it's actually the midnight blue color, which was a color that they offered. The one on the right, which is the replica, is more like the pewter finish that was also offered on the Eric Clapton models. So let's start the comparison actually up at the top of the guitar at the headstocks. Now with the two headstocks side by side, that may look like the one on the right is a little bit larger, but that's just the angle of the guitars that I have them now to try and get them close together. So again, that's not something that you would look for to tell if it was a fake or not. But some of the big things to look for are the string trees. So you'll notice that on the fake one, there's two string trees, and on the real custom shop model, there's just the one. Now, this isn't always the case with all fake Fender guitars that a simple string tree would be the telling factor, but as I go through these different things, if you're looking at a guitar to buy and you're trying to figure out if it's a legitimate Fender guitar or if it's a fake, these are some things to look for, and it's not just one thing, but usually a collection of things that will help you to determine whether it's actually legit or a fake. Now, you'll notice on the fake one on the right, there is the signature here that says Eric Clapton and it says Blackie underneath, and that doesn't appear on the signature model. But I have seen some Eric Clapton models that do have the signature that way. So again, that's not necessarily something that will determine whether it's fake or not. Another key feature here is the logo that says Fender. You can see that the fake one on the right is using a pretty similar font. It looks pretty good. The color is a little bit off and the placement is a little bit off. You can see how far away it is from the edge here compared to on the real one. You'll also notice that the tuning keys are a little bit different. The Eric Clapton model has the vintage style that are open on top, whereas this one has the closed tops. Now, probably the biggest difference between these two headstocks is the truss rod adjustment hole. On the real model, it has the walnut insert, whereas on the fake one, it's just empty. And quite often that is an indicator of a lower quality neck. A lot of times on a squire neck, you'll see that type of a hole. But if it's a real legitimate custom shop model, especially the Eric Clapton model, it will definitely have that walnut insert for the truss rod hole. Now the nut on the Eric Clapton model is synthetic bone, whereas the fake one here is definitely plastic. And you can really feel the difference when you feel the two of them. On the back of the headstock, you'll notice that both of these guitars have the similar looking tuning keys. They're the vintage style. But you'll notice on the fake Stratocaster that they're not lined up very well. A few of them are a little bit crooked, whereas the real Fender one here are perfectly straight. You'll also notice the placement of the signature decal is a little bit off on the fake one here compared to the real one. And the custom shop logo is in the right place, but if you look carefully, you'll see that the quality of the printing of the custom shop logo is not very good on the fake one. The real Clapton model, the font is very crisp and clear, whereas the fake one, the font is a little bit different and it's also kind of blurry and not very sharp on the edges. Also, the fake one has this serial number on here, which I'll talk about in a minute, but you'll notice that there isn't one here on the Clapton model. That's because the Clapton model has the serial number on the neck plate. And we'll look at that in a few minutes. What's interesting about the serial number on the fake one is that is actually a legitimate serial number. So I entered that number on a website where you can check your Stratocaster serial number and it'll tell you what year it was made and which factory it came from. When I put that number in, the website suggested that this guitar was made in Corona, California. Now we know that that's not the case because of the other things that we've seen here that are indicating that this is a fake. So then when I Googled that serial number, I found that that is a serial number that is used a lot. So I found a lot of Google images that have that same serial number. And I also found some other guitars that were for sale at different auctions that also had that same serial number. So that number is obviously something that they have mass produced on a decal and they're putting on various different guitars. And then that's why there's a lot more of these guitars out there, different ones, not just Clapton models, but various models that are out there with this serial number on it. You'll also notice that the shape of the edge of the headstock here is different on the two guitars. This one is a very pronounced shape because it leads into the V shape of the Clapton neck, whereas this one is more rounded off and that ends up going into more of a flat neck. Now moving to the back of the bodies, on the Eric Clapton model, we'll notice on the neck plate, it does have the serial number as well as the custom shop logo. Whereas on the fake model, it says Fender and Corona, California, but it doesn't have the serial number or the custom shop logo. Now on the back plate of the guitar, there's an interesting detail that's often missed on the fake ones. On the legitimate one here over on the left, you'll notice that these center screw holes are offset, whereas on the fake model, they're lined up straight across. And that's quite common with the fake Stratocasters. They don't do the offset on that plate for some reason. The fake one is also a little bit wider. It may not be easy to see that on the video, but it's actually probably about half an inch wider than the real Fender. Now, looking at the front again, there's not a lot of really obvious things that jump out when you're looking at the front of the guitar until you kind of get close and see some of the details. Now, probably the most obvious thing that you can see here is the number of screws that are holding the pickguard in. You'll see that on this fake model, there is two extra screws that are not on the Eric Clapton model, which is more like the vintage pickguards. And along with that vintage look, the Eric Clapton pickguard is a single ply of plastic, whereas the fake one is a double ply with the little bit of black in the middle there as well. Now the bridges of the guitar do look similar, but when you look closely, you'll see that the style of the saddles is different on both guitars. In the Eric Clapton model, they're the vintage style saddles, and each individual saddle is stamped with the word Fender. On the fake model, they don't say Fender on them. Now, on the pickups themselves, they say Noiseless on them, which is a type of pickup that is used in the Eric Clapton model. But on the fake one, the font on the word Noiseless is not quite right. It's a little bit larger than the real one. And also the edges of the letters are not clear like they are on the legitimate Fender. Now the necks themselves, it's hard to really see much of a difference when you're looking right at it. However, the dots at the 12th fret are the wider spacing on the fake one on the right, and the Eric Clapton model on the left has the narrower, more vintage spacing. But there definitely is a difference in the feel of the neck. Like I mentioned earlier, the Clapton model has the V-shaped neck, whereas the other one has more of a standard C-shape. And of course, Eric Clapton was well known for using a V-shaped neck, and so his signature model is going to have that V-shape. Another piece of evidence that the legitimate custom shop Stratocaster came with was this certificate of authenticity. Now this has the model number with the matching serial number and the date that the guitar was manufactured. Now you could make a fake certificate as well, but you'll want to check that it has the stamped raised lettering. So both the Fender logo on top here and the Custom Shop logo down below are both actually stamped into the paper. So when I feel this, I can see even on the back here that it is raised lettering. And that would be something that would be a little bit more difficult to duplicate. If you're looking to buy a Stratocaster, particularly on the used market, you want to make sure that you look at some of the things that we discussed today. And remember that it's not just one thing that will determine whether it's a fake or not, but it's usually a collection of a number of things. There's a lot of different models and options, so there might be some variance from one guitar to another, but there are some key things. If you're seeing a lot of red flags, that's probably a good indicator that this is not a legitimate Fender. If you have any more tips about how to spot a fake Fender, then leave them in the comments below so that the rest of us can learn from it. Or if you have a question about a Fender that you've maybe already purchased, then leave that down in the comments as well, and we'll try to help you figure out if what you have is a legitimate Fender or not. If you found this helpful, then please help me out by hitting the like button and subscribe to the channel if you want to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.